It looks pretty sleek. Like, I was kind of expecting it to have a department store feel, just based off of, you know, where it's from and the cost, because it's what, like $1,500?
I think it's $1,500 retail, or $1,700, but they're on sale for $13, I want to say.
Okay, so let's just say $15.
We'll say take $15, the average.
Yeah. $1,500 for an e-bike. I was expecting crap, because the average e-bike is, what, $7,000?
At least,
for
yeah.
For something good?
For something good, yeah.
This thing feels good. Like, it doesn't feel like, I thought it was going to be a Huffy. It doesn't feel like a Huffy just looking at it. It's not light, but, I mean, it's also not meant to be sending jumps, so I'm kind of excited to ride it. This is going to be fun.
Hell yeah, dude. This is going to be awesome.
Now, here's the question. Can I get it in my truck? It's 65 pounds, is that right?
65 pounds, yeah.
Let's find out. Okay, I almost feel like I need to strategize for this. With my e-bike, I usually just grab it right here.
Keep in mind, all the weight's in the back too, so it's weird.
It is. Should I try like this? I'm gonna try to load the same way I load my e-bike.
Looks light.
Oh my God. Okay, I got it in the truck. Not bad. Let's go ride.
All right.
Good morning, mountain bikers. I'm Chris Wessels, and you are watching MTB Trail Review. Today, I'm doing something a little bit off-brand for me. If you have been paying attention to the world around you, you have seen a major increase in the amount of e-bikes, not just on the trail, but really everywhere. Here in San Diego, anytime you go out, you're going to see somebody on an e-bike. They are everywhere. And I'm going to go out on a limb and say that the rest of the country looks very similar. Today, I'm reviewing a bike that's really similar to the ones that you have seen all over the place, and not so much on the trail. My buddy Dan picked this thing up, and I just kind of wanted to try it. I've been very curious about these. I think they have a lot of really good applications. I think there's a lot of places that'll be really fun, and I'll talk all about that. But today, the whole point is to see if this bike is trail worthy, and if it is trail worthy, what type of trails should you be taking a bike like this on? Or should this bike be reserved for things like sand, snow, and a daily commute? Enjoy the ride. Okay, this is a pretty basic trail. This is what I imagine you would want to ride these bikes on. Let's see how it does. I'm going to take it over a couple rocks on purpose. So one thing I'm noticing immediately with the pedal assist is if you go and then stop, it takes a minute for the motor to unengage, I guess is the word. Hello. Hello. Ah. That was fine. So going downhill, that's just something you would want to be prepared for. Also, we have mechanical disc brakes, so no one finger braking with these. You know, we're gonna go this way, we're gonna go the harder way. Okay. I mean, it definitely doesn't compare to my Kona, but it's not supposed to. So, gotta keep that in mind. Did I get the back wheel even close to off the ground?
Huh?
Did I even, like, was the back wheel even trying to get up?
That was a solid 2-3 inches,
dude. Really? It came off?
Yeah.
Okay. So I got this bike in the air. I wasn't sure if I was gonna be able to. Okay, here we go. Whew. This thing's kind of a blast. Okay, this bike carries all the momentum in the world. Okay, it doesn't want to stop. That could be a good thing or a bad thing. So this type of trail right here is what this bike was designed for. We're gonna try it on something harder.
Oh my God. Okay, so for a bike that's not like a meant to be a hardcore mountain bike, number one, it's doing pretty well. And number two, it's fun in like a new challenge type of way. Like, I'm gonna stop and I wanna include Dan on this. I just wanna get his perspective. So you know how Alex takes his gravel bike out on trails he's not supposed to take it out on? I imagine he feels how I feel on this bike right now, riding stuff around here. Like, it's really fun because it's a different kind of challenge.
Exactly.
Does that make sense?
That makes a lot of sense. It doesn't do what this bike will do, for instance.
No.
It's just a different line.
And it's not. I mean, that at this point, with the upgrades that Chainline has done for me, that's a $9,000 to $10,000 bike.
Yep.
This is a $1,500 bike, and I'm having a ton of fun on it. Let's go. Okay. I'm kind of scared.
You want to take it out first?
I think I can go a little faster. How'd it look?
Got it off the ground.
Did I really?
Yeah, like no joke, man.
So this trail right here, or I should say this section of trail, is where we decided to push the bike a little bit past what it was intended for. This trail has some actual rocks on it. It has a decent sized rock garden. And once again, you can't tell by the video, but this trail is steep enough to where you can really carry some downhill speed. I had to pick my lines, and I had to think about controlling my speed through these rock gardens. The fat tires made for a very plush ride. The fork was clinking and clanging a little bit, but it held up fine. And once again, I am a roughly 250 pound rider. I'm on the edge of this bike's weight limit. I'm also on the edge of the bike's height limit. And it was still a very comfortable bike to ride. Even though this section was a little scary, I had a lot of fun. And I'll give you my full thoughts in just a few minutes here.
Holy shit.
But
real mountain biking now.
I'm just gonna go and say it right now, I kinda want one. This was a lot of fun in a very different way. And I'm thinking about all of the other places that I would love to go ride this bike. Namely, in the snow, taking it up on the beach, maybe just going for like a little, you know, 20 to 25 mile country adventure. This bike has a lot of uses outside of trail riding.
Okay. Stop and chat for a second.
All right.
So, at any point, tell me if I'm being a little too proud of myself.
Oh, God.
I would say I'm a high intermediate to low advanced rider. Would you agree?
I'll agree with that statement.
I would say that is a low intermediate to high beginner level trail.
Agreed.
Would you agree?
I agree with that.
That was scary, if I'm being honest. This bike carries so much momentum, and it's so hard to stop it and to kind of control your speed and pick your lines. So I'm just gonna say right now, this bike is good on beginner trails. I wouldn't take it on anything harder than a beginner trail. I think you would be putting yourself in danger. Yep. With some upgrades, you might be able to. If you got hydraulic disc brakes, maybe. If you got a better fork, maybe then you could take it on some harder trails. But, I mean, for that stuff, it handled great. I think on fire roads, like on the beach, in the snow, this thing's gonna be a blast. And it definitely has its place. Its place is not on intermediate plus mountain bike trails.
Okay.
So we've talked a lot about the downhill. Haven't talked much about this thing's ability to climb. So climbing is a breeze. And you can't tell, but this trail is steep. Somebody did some building over here. I don't like it. That was fun the way it was. So this is extremely steep, pretty technical, and the bike's eating it up. So, I mean, that's really what you're buying this for. is to help you climb steep trails to get to the places where you normally really wouldn't be able to go. Okay, so we've kind of put this thing through the ringer. Like, if I'm being honest, we haven't been nice to it because we really wanted to see what it would do. So Dan's just giving it a quick once over, checking the spokes. So far, they're all good. The rim is still in alignment, and I'm a 250-ish pound man that did some stuff this bike's not meant to do. Derailleur's still good. The shifting's still good.
Looks better dirty, for sure.
The fork is still working. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, it's not.
It still works.
It's fine. It's fine. Which, I mean, go high boy. Because we just bashed this thing. Like, it, this bike is not designed to do what we just did on it.
But it's doing better than I thought it was. I have to admit, it's doing way better than I thought it would do.
Okay.
Okay.
So, I'm just going to give you my thoughts. I'm sure Dan has some thoughts too. If I were a very casual rider, if I'm going to go out on beginner trails, if I'm going to hit a bunch of fire roads, maybe the occasional snow ride, if I'm going to commute, if I'm going to do basically not what I normally do, which is hardcore mountain biking, this is a great bike. It's a great bike for everything but hardcore mountain biking. It's still good for light trails. Because once again, the stuff that we took it down today, that was not light trails. I took it through some real rock gardens. I took it down this slab. We took it over some of this stuff, and it handled it all really well. Dan, what do you think?
I think if you're looking for a commuter bike that has the ability to do very, very light off-roading, I think it's actually a really good bike. One thing I noticed about it, it's a ton of fun to ride.
I agree. It is, and it's a different kind of fun. Like,
yeah,
taking this bike on more challenging obstacles, it's fun because it's not as capable as the bikes that we're used to. So it almost tests our skill a little bit more.
Yeah.
Like, lets us know where we really stand, you know?
It's almost like going back to basics. Like, yeah. There's nothing tricky about this bike. There's nothing crazy. It does have a lot of power, shockingly enough. Like, the motor does.
This thing flies uphill.
It hauls butt.
It's almost scary. When yeah. I was coming up this, I didn't have my camera on, but I was coming up this, I was like, oh God, oh God.
The only thing I would like to see if Highboy makes a plus model or the next generation for me is the hydraulic brakes. This thing is a little scary when it gets up to speed.
I agree.
Other than that, I'm actually genuinely surprised.
The only other thing that I'll say too is I would change these pedals. If you're gonna use it for trail riding, they just don't have much grip.
Yeah.
So if you're gonna use this bike for trail riding, get something with a little bit more grip. It doesn't have to be this, like the ones that I have on my bike. You know, you don't need $200 pedals for this thing.
Get a $20 pair of flat pedals off of Amazon and yeah. You'll be fine with
pins that are just a little bit bigger.
It's a little better.
But yeah, outside of the pedals and the brakes, I think you can
have a lot of fun on this bike. And you can do a lot on this bike too. I'm blown away by it actually. I'm shocked. That's all. I was expecting Walmart grade and it's not Walmart grade.
It's not at all.
So
wow. If you have any questions about the bike, leave them in the comments. I will definitely answer them. If I don't have the answer, I bet Dan will. I'll call him and say, hey, answer that comment. As always, thanks for hitting the trails with us. Catch you on the next one.